In this video, I'll be going over 10 great tips for using the Letter Tiles app with All About Reading and All About Spelling. My little assistant will be helping with the demonstrations. Ready? Let's begin! For our first tip, let's talk about adding tiles to the letter building area. You can add tiles using three methods. You can drag, swipe, or just tap the letter to add it above. Which method do you prefer? Did you know you can move a word on the screen after it's built? It's really easy to reposition any word you build. You might know that you can use one finger to move an individual tile, but if you use two fingers, you can move the entire word. Need to remove some tiles? If you want to remove just one tile, drag or swipe the tile down towards the storage area. To remove all the tiles, just drag one tile to the top of the screen. When you are scrolling through the letter storage area, try using two fingers. This way, you won't accidentally grab letter tiles as you scroll. You can also use the category tabs to quickly find the letter tile you're searching for. For example, if you need a vowel team tile, just touch the vowel team text to go right to that category. If you touch and hold a letter tile, you will see a few options pop up. Using these options, you can either capitalize the tile, or you can hear the different sounds the phonogram on the tile makes.
I-E.
In the drop-down menu in the upper right, you can either choose All About Reading, All About Spelling, or All Tiles. If you choose All Tiles, you have the option of having all tiles available from both programs in the storage area. Did you know that you can lock the screen? Suppose you want to lock the letter tiles in place so they cannot be moved. For example, if your child prefers to use her finger to slide under the word as she sounds it out, she might get frustrated if by doing so she accidentally moves the tile around. To avoid this, just lock the screen. Press the lock icon in the navigation area above the word building area. You can unlock the screen by pressing the lock again. If your child is having a hard time spelling a word, you can narrow the options by placing a limited number of tiles in the word building area. Now, your child can easily find the letters to spell the word without feeling overwhelmed. Have you ever noticed the light gray boxes that appear when you tap on the word building area? These boxes are placeholders and can be moved around just like a regular tile. They're also known as Elkonin boxes, and they can help children segment words into their individual sounds. These placeholders can be used in various situations. One way to use them is with lessons where your child must pick a certain tile to use, such as whether to use a C or a K at the beginning of a word. However, if your child finds these boxes frustrating, you can always turn them off in the settings menu. It's time to divide syllables. You can divide any word you build by touching the two tiles where you want the split. Then drag outwards. You can move these parts with the tip we covered earlier by using two fingers and dragging. Now, go ahead and label them. Hopefully, these tips will help you get the most out of your Letter Tiles app. Before I go, here's a bonus tip. If you're worried you won't remember everything I've talked about here, there are videos right in the app you can watch to refresh your memory. To find them, click on the Settings menu. Next, click on either Overview or Advanced Features to watch the videos. When you're finished, touch the screen and find the X button to close the video. Happy reading and spelling!